Here is a problem. The sum of the magnitude of two forces acting at a point is 16 newtons. If the resultant is normal to the smaller force and has a magnitude of 8 newtons, then find the forces. Let us show the construction. Assume that this is a smaller force F1 and this is the larger force F2. And this is the resultant of the two forces F, which is given to be normal to the given force, smaller force. Assume that this angle is theta. Now, first of all, he says that the sum of the magnitude, that means F1 plus F2 is equal to, it is given to be 8. Sorry, it is given to be 16. This is given to be 16. And he also says us that the resultant is normal to the smaller force and has a magnitude of 8 newtons. So, magnitude of the resultant force is 8 newtons. So, I have equation number 1. If we can generate one more equation between F1 and F2, we will be able to solve. Let us see how to do this. To do this, let us resolve this F2 into components. Suppose I resolve this F2 into components, I have F2 cos theta and F2 sin theta. F2 cos theta and F2 sin theta. Thus, F2 sin theta is equal to F1, and we also have F2 cos theta is equal to F, which is 8. So now let me call this as equation number 2 and equation number 3. 2 square plus 3 square. That gives us F2 square into sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to F1 square plus 64. That is, F2 square is equal to F1 square plus 64. So now, I will rewrite it like this. F2 square minus F1 square is equal to 64. Or this is F2 minus F1 into F2 plus F1 is equal to 64. But we know this value, right? F2 minus F1 is not known, whereas F2 plus F1 is known. There's nothing but 16 from equation number 1. So what do we have? F2 minus F1 is equal to 64 divided by 16, that is 4. So I have F2 plus F1 is equal to 16 from equation 1, and F2 minus F1 is equal to 4. If we add them, we get F2 is equal to, what are the values? F2 is equal to 10 newtons and F1 is equal to. So if you look at it, F1 is nothing but 16 minus 10, so 10 newtons, 6 newtons. So F2 is 10 and F1 is 6.